Good morning, my dear students. Welcome in the class 8 IIT. I am Mr. Yogeshwari and I am going to teach you maths. Today, this is our first lecture in the class 8 and we are going to start with the first chapter, rational numbers. Okay. So, in this chapter, rational number, what we are going to learn throughout the chapter, that we will see first. We will take revision. Revision of, as this is the chapter rational numbers. Okay, so we will revise the all kinds of numbers which we have learned till now, and along with that we will learn the concept of rational numbers. Okay, after that we will see positive and negative rational numbers. Okay, then equivalent rational numbers, standard form of rational number, comparison of rational number. So these three concepts which we have learned in the chapter fraction, equivalent fraction, then standard form of fraction or comparison of fraction, we have learned in the chapter fraction. Same concepts are there in the rational numbers. So we will try to correlate with them, whether these three concepts which are there in the rational number are related with the concept which are there in the fraction. That we will see. Then we are going to learn absolute value of rational number. Okay. This absolute value, this concept we have learned in which chapter, we remember? Yes, we have learned in the chapter integer. Okay. Absolute value means what? Same concept we are going to learn in the case of rational number also. Then we have presentation of rational number on the number line. Till now the numbers which we have learned, we have also learned to represent them on the number line, locate them on the number line. Similarly, we will learn to locate the rational numbers on the number line. Then we have operations on rational number. Operations means addition, subtraction, multiplication and division in the case of rational number. So we are going to learn how to add or subtract or multiply and divide the rational number, and then its properties. Which are properties? In last year, in 7th class, you have learned the properties. Those properties were related with the integers. Okay. So here, which those properties are? Closure property, commutative, associativity and distributivity. Okay. So these four properties we are going to learn in the case of rational number. Okay. Then we have rational numbers between. Finding rational numbers between two given rational numbers. As you know that we can find numbers between any two whole numbers or any two integers. Similarly, we will learn to find rational numbers between any two rational numbers. Okay, and then what problems which are related with the rational numbers. So these all concepts, 11 concepts or 10 concepts excluding division, 10 concepts we are going to learn in this chapter. So be ready and make up your mind to learn the rational number. So let's see the first concept.
So let us see the introduction of rational numbers. Okay. To learn rational numbers, first we must understand that till now which numbers or which kind of numbers we have studied throughout the earlier classes. Okay, so initially here I have written one, I have drawn number line, and using this number line we are going to revise those numbers. Okay, so initially in earlier classes we have seen the counting numbers, to count, for example, to count some things or to count the number of students in your class. We have used those counting numbers, starting with the, whenever we count anything we start with the 1, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, likewise. So such numbers are called counting number, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and so on. Okay, counting number starts with the 1 and they do not end. There are infinite counting numbers, and such counting numbers are said to be, what is name of these counting numbers? Natural numbers. We say they natural numbers. Okay. natural numbers means nothing but counting numbers, the numbers which we use to count. For example, natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay? Understood? So these are natural numbers starting with the 1. Now, in this natural number, if here we add 0 on the number line before natural number, if we add 0, now they becomes the set of whole number. It becomes the set of whole numbers. Okay. So secondly, we have learned about whole numbers. If you remember, in 6th class we have learned about the whole numbers. And whole numbers means what? 0 plus all these natural numbers. Whole numbers means 0 plus all natural numbers. Or we will say 0 and all natural numbers are called whole numbers. So whole set of whole numbers start with the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. We can write here n. N numbers means uncountable, okay? So whenever we say which is the first whole number, then first whole number is 0, whereas first natural number is 1. Understood? Whole number start with the 0, 0 and all other natural numbers makes the set of whole numbers. Okay? Now here, based on this information, the question can be asked. See, what facts we can obtain? All natural numbers are whole number, but all whole numbers are not natural. Getting what I am telling? All natural numbers, because natural numbers, since natural numbers start with the 1 and all those natural numbers comes here in the set of whole number, that's why we can say that all natural numbers are whole numbers, but all whole numbers are not natural, because here in whole number there is 0 which is not natural number. That's why all whole numbers are not natural. Okay. Now, if we extend this number line again towards the left, what we will obtain? Can you tell me, can you guess, if we extend this number line on the left side? Here there is 0, on the right of the 0 there are natural numbers, counting numbers, right? So on the left of the 0, what we can obtain? Yes, you have learned that in the last class. Yes, negative of those natural numbers. So here 0, then here minus 1, then minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7 and so on. Uncountable, okay? So positive, their negatives and 0. This is the set of integers, okay? So third type of numbers we have learned, that is nothing but integers. So integers means what? Positive, their negatives, positive numbers, generally they are said to be natural numbers, their negatives and 0 are called, or the set of this is called as integers. So integers is equal to negative numbers, we start here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, similarly here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay, so this is the set of integers. So till this, we have these three types of numbers we have learned. We have learned in the earlier classes: natural numbers, whole numbers and integers. Okay. Now, addition in this, what is the fourth type of number we are going to learn? That is rational numbers. Now, what is mean by these rational numbers? What is mean by rational numbers? We have seen natural numbers means starting counting numbers, whole numbers means zero plus zero and natural numbers, integers means positive numbers, their negative numbers and zero. Okay. Now rational numbers means what? Rational numbers means what? See. First we will see the definition of rational number. Rational numbers means the numbers which can be expressed in the form of P upon Q. Let us write here the numbers which can be expressed in the form of P upon Q. P upon Q means P is the numerator, Q is the denominator. Means this type of form of the number we have seen in the which topic? Fraction, right? So P upon Q, where P and Q are integers. Where P and Q are integers. Integers means this. Positive, negative or zero. So P and Q should be any two integers and another one condition is that Q must not equal to zero. Getting? Rational numbers means the numbers that can be expressed in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q must not be equal to zero. Q is not equal to zero means any number. For example, here there is 5. 5 has denominator 1, right? So 5 upon 1. So that's why this 5 is rational number. Minus 5, it also has denominator 1. We have seen this in the fraction. So minus 5 is also rational number. Okay. Minus 7 upon 8. Rational number. Or we have 73 upon 100. That is 73%. It is also rational number. Okay. A decimal is also rational number. 5 upon 7 is also rational number. Why? Because it can be expressed in the form of P upon Q. You know that 5 upon 7 means 57 upon 10, correct? So 5.7 can be expressed in the form of P upon Q, numerator and denominator. Okay, so this is also rational number. But see, 6 upon 0, is it rational number? 6 upon 0, is it rational number? No. Why? Because see, as I told you, Q must not be equal to 0. Q means your denominator. Denominator must not be 0. Because the answer of 6 upon 0 does not exist. And it is not defined. Okay? It is not defined. So, its answer does not exist. That's why there must not be, denominator must not be 0. So, this is not rational number. Or any minus 7 upon 0, this is also not rational number. Okay, got it? So rational numbers, basically rational numbers means what? The numbers, such numbers which can be expressed in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q must not be equal to 0. Okay, P means nothing but numerator, Q means denominator. Here there can be any other alphabets also, A upon B, C upon D, okay? Means they represent the numerator and the denominator. P is numerator, Q is the denominator. Understood? So this is the concept of rational number. Write this in your notebook. After that we will see the concepts now which are related with the rational number. Okay, so first concept in the rational number is positive and negative rational numbers. Okay, so when we can say that the given rational number is positive or it is negative? See, a rational number can be said as a positive. First we talk about positive rational number. A rational number can be said to be positive if
its numerator and denominator both are either positive or both negative. Have you understood? If numerator and denominator both are positive or both are negative, then that rational number can be said as a positive rational number. Means what? See, for example, 4 upon 9. See here, in this rational number, both numerator and denominator are positive. Correct? Plus plus. Plus 4 plus 9. Okay? Similarly, 25 upon 100. Here also both numerators are positive. That's why they are positive rational numbers. Okay? Whereas, minus 9 upon minus 20. Here also both numerator and denominator are negative. That's why it is also positive rational number. As I told you the definition, rational numbers can be said to be positive if its numerator and denominator both are positive or both are negative. Then that rational number can be said to be positive. Okay, so here both are positive, that's why it is positive rational number. And here both are negative, both numerator and denominator are negative. That's why it is also positive rational number. Why? Because this minus divided by minus, as we say, 5 divided by 5 is cut. Similarly, minus divided by minus will also get cut and it becomes a positive. Okay, that's why if both numerator and denominator have negative sign, then that rational number becomes positive. Okay? For example, we can give minus 30 upon minus 70. It is also positive rational number. Okay? And opposite of that, negative rational numbers means what? If a rational number can be said as a negative if its numerator or denominator is negative. Anyone out of numerator and denominator, anyone is negative. For example, here 4 upon minus 9. If it is 4 upon minus 9, in this numerator is positive but denominator is negative. That's why this rational number becomes negative rational number. Or here minus 25 upon plus 100. Minus 25 upon 100. So here numerator is negative and denominator is positive. Anyone is negative, that's why it is negative rational number. Okay? Or 9 upon minus 20 or minus 30 upon 70. This minus sign is common for this fraction. That's why it is also rational number, a negative rational number. Okay? Understood? When rational number can be said as a positive and when can be said as a negative? Once again I repeat, if both numerator and denominators are positive or both numerator and denominators are negative, then that rational numbers can be said as a positive rational number. Whereas, if anyone out of numerator and denominator, any one is negative, then that rational number will be negative. Okay? Now the next concept is equivalent rational numbers. So this first let us see concept of equivalent means what. We have learned this concept in the fraction. Okay, equivalent means having equal value, though the fraction looks different but it has same value. Such fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. Similarly here, equivalent rational numbers means rational numbers which looks different but the value is same. Such rational numbers are called equivalent rational numbers. Now the topic is how to find the rational numbers. Equivalent rational numbers. Let us see if there is any one rational number minus 2 upon 3. Okay? There are two methods of finding equivalent rational numbers. First method is by multiplying and second method is by dividing. So first we will see how, by multiplying, how to use the method of multiplication. Okay, given rational number is minus 2 upon 3. The question is, find the four equivalent rational numbers of minus 2 upon 3. How to find? You see, our given rational number is minus 2 upon 3. So minus 2 upon 3. To find its equivalent rational number, what we have to do? We have to multiply both numerator and denominator by same natural number. Same, or we can say same integers, non-zero integers. Okay? So it may be 2 or 2's are multiplied by 2, multiplied by 2. If you multiply numerator by 2, so the same number we have to multiply to the denominator. So we will get here 2 into minus 2, minus 4 upon 3 2's are 6. Again, minus 2 upon 3, multiply by, we can multiply it by 3 here, 3. To both the numerator and denominator. So we get here minus 6 upon 9, right? Similarly, minus 2 upon 3, we can multiply here by 5. We get here 5 minus 2, minus 10 upon 5, 3 is 15. Minus 2 upon 3 into 100, into 100. Any number, but it must be same in the numerator and denominator. By same number, we have to multiply to both numerator and denominator, so here we get minus 200 upon 300. Okay, so these are four equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions of minus 2 upon 3 is equivalent rational numbers of minus 2 upon 3 is minus 4 upon 6, minus 6 upon 9. Minus 10 upon 15 and minus 200 upon 300. So there can be uncountable, infinite equivalent rational numbers to the given rational numbers. If it is asked to find next four or in sequence, then here we have to multiply by 2, then 3, then 4, then 5 in sequence. Okay? But if they have asked to find any four equivalent rational numbers of the given, then we can multiply by any integer, any non-zero integer. Okay, because except 0, we can multiply by any integer to both numerator and denominator. So this is way of multiplication. Let us see how to find equivalent fractions by division. Okay, so suppose there is minus 32 upon 48. There is rational number minus 32 upon 48, and we have to find its equivalent rational numbers. Then what to do? As you know that these two numbers or two integers are quite bigger. Okay? So what we have to do? Minus 32 upon 48. We have to divide both numerator and denominator by their common factor. We have to divide both numerator and denominator by their common factor. Now 32 and 48, minus 32 and 48 are divisible by which same number or which are their factor? There are so many factors, common factors of 32 and 48. There is 2, 4, both are a table of 2, 4, 8, correct? Then a table of 16. So we can here divide by 2, both the numerator and denominator, we get here minus 16 upon 24. Then secondly, we will divide by 4. So here we get minus 8 upon 12. Correct? Then again, we will divide it by 8. We get minus 4 upon 6, correct? Then minus 32 upon 48 divided by 16. So we get here minus 2 upon 3. correct? So equivalent fractions, equivalent rational numbers of minus 32 upon 48 are minus 16 upon 24, minus 8 upon 12, minus 4 upon 6, minus 2 upon 3. Okay, what we have to do? We have to divide both numerator and denominator by same common factor. Okay, here divide by 2, then in the denominator also divide by 2. Understood? So, in this way, in these two ways, we can find the equivalent rational numbers of the given rational number. And as I told you, there are uncountable equivalent rational numbers. Okay, so in today's lecture, we have talked about the concept of rational number. We have discussed about the positive and negative rational numbers, how to identify positive and negative rational numbers, then how to find equivalent rational numbers. So watch this video very carefully, and if you have any doubt in this, we talk in the during the Google Meet after this video. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.